but we're really going to hit the teres minor, teres major, since those are primary movers with the retraction. But we're mostly going to hit that spine. That's just going to relax all the tissue going out. And then we'll get into the upper pec, the anterior delta, and the bicep, just so the shoulder mobility still stays pretty smooth and he can still perform for a longer period of time instead of fatiguing faster. So I'm gonna turn the light off. Let me know if you need me to.
I can just I fix the light here.
Okay. No worries. I can always do this light.
No, it's perfect. You can just work with your light and I just fix it here. Yeah, it looks cool actually. Oh yeah.
Like this one?
Oh yeah, it looks
cool. Yeah, nice. Mm-hmm. We'll stick with this. That way it looks better, especially when you edit.
Oh yeah.
Everything will look better. But yeah, we're gonna start right on this bottom QL and work our way up the lats all the way through. So he trains later today?
Yeah, F4. Right after here actually.
Okay,
good. After.
Will he be training with flex at all a little bit?
Yes.
Yeah.
Flex, he has a lot of things in this week, mm-hmm. but they're trying to coordinate, I think, next week.
Nice. Yeah, Flex is a busy guy.
Yes, he is. A lot of business to take care of it.
Yeah, so right now I'm just warming up the connective tissue mm-hmm. on the lat. The more we can release the tension on the fascia, mm-hmm. the more we can just work on the lat itself. It'll respond a whole lot faster.
That's cool.
Instead of just going straight to the lat. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's just my approach. All the time I like to work on the attachment points in the connective tissue.
That makes sense.
And
sometimes it's not exactly in a place, right?
Yeah.
Something connected to it.
But yeah, the more we do that, it starts to expose more of what the lat is really gonna, what we can really do. Mm-hmm. So now we can just focus on this lat right here and push it all the way out. Thank you.